Good afternoon, ladies and gents. Moneybags McP down here with Jake. We're gonna do our top five schoolie lures. I know it's kind of in the middle of winter here, but it'll be April, May before you know it, and we'll be hitting the beaches, back bays, with some of the lures we got here today.
Well, I sure am excited. I know this guy is. He won't stop talking about
it. I can't sleep.
Let's start off with some soft plastics. I have right here, this is my go-to for schoolie season. 4.5 dot spin. I love it in every color. It can be white. It can be silver over silver. It can be chartreuse. I don't care. Double pepper, you name it. Great bait. For the bigger fish, I go to the 5.5. I like it. Bigger profile, especially if you've got the chub swimming around, which is a very prevalent bait in these back bays.
Super
sure.
Chubby.
Something new for you guys. I fished it a little bit last year. Did all right in both freshwater and saltwater. And it is the worm spin. You guys have not seen this before. I fish it with just a jig head, standard like half ounce, quarter ounce.
Yep.
Not really the EWG hook that it comes with, just because I want to get that extra distance and fish it a little bit lower in the water column.
Yep.
But that's my soft plastics.
And that glow color too, the chartreuse. If it ain't chartreuse, can't get loose.
Keep an eye out on it for this year for sure.
Mm-hmm. So cracking into some of my soft plastics. I love these Bill Hurleys. This is the little mini squids. I got in kind of the tangerine flake with the silver and then the all silver here. These are 5 inches. They do have a weighted hook in them, so they're about 3/4 of an ounce. These guys cast surprisingly well for their size. I love the big ones for monomoy rips. They're just a go-to for me. I love them.
And they're only 10 bucks.
They're only 10 bucks. You get a 4-pack here. Squid scent. So
squid scent.
Yeah.
Two of them are rigged.
Yep. Nice 7-foot medium rod. Will cast this very well and just works awesome. All right. So this is basically, I'm trying to get a good camera view on this. This is the 6-inch Ronzi silver metallic. And this is probably my first catcher of the year. I mean, for what, 5 years running now. So 1 ounce jig head. This will cast really far. Nice little slim profile though. Stout hooks, if you get that that slot fish or maybe even above slot fishing with the schoolies, you don't have to worry about dropping that.
Yeah, you definitely catch a mixed bag, especially in the early year, those holdovers that are coming out in that warmer water.
Yep.
Ron Z, the amount of fish that we must have caught in Ron Z's must be just incredible.
Just insane. I love them. High quality. All right.
Gross.
Grubby, I pretty much will either rig them on a plane on a jig head, or as everybody knows, I did a bucktail fishing video, refer to it, boop, 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 boop. Bucktail, 3/4 ounce to 1 ounce is probably my preferred weight. We got the sand eel here, which is just like a white over olive, and then either white or glow here, kind of mimicking the same thing he had going with the worm spin there. And I would probably rig with either like a pearl or the silver flake. These Spro grubs are nice and big, so you get a lot of action with them. They're scented, and again, a pretty good bargain there.
For sure, it's hard to beat a bucktail.
Yeah,
early schoolie season, it really is.
That's the other thing. So I like to use a single hook when I can. These are really nice for catch and release. You don't have treble hooks going all crazy. You get them back in the water quickly.
Well, he's kind of making me look bad because now I'm going to talk about some lures with decent amount of treble hooks on them. I personally take them off. Right here is my go-to for topwater schoolies, the Daddy Mac AB Bomb.
Yeah.
Hard to beat, great action, super light, so I use it on a real lightweight rod. Like, I'm using my largemouth bass gear pretty much all the time.
That's
for schoolies. 2500 series reel. Listen to that rattle.
Oh yeah.
That gets them juiced up. I do replace the hooks. I usually put, I keep this front travel, a little bit better travel because it kind of needs it.
Yeah.
And then usually put like a single, if anything, on the back, but it's usually just for weight that I put that single on there.
Right.
Going to one of my recent finds, the Magdotta 105 floating.
Yep.
What a profile. You know, kind of similar here to this dart spin.
Right.
Mimics these little chubs incredibly, and it's super easy to fish. You cast it out, you can fish it from the shore on a light setup, on the boat from an even lighter setup. Great way to catch fish and stout hooks. I don't have to change them like the AB Bomb. Sorry, Daddy Mac. Don't roast me in the comments. And my sleeper pick.
Ooh.
My sleeper pick. This guy put me onto it, to be fair. A couple years ago, we were fishing, tossing epoxies on a real windy day. McP here why he's called the money bag is he gave me a little epoxy with a little, like, teaser, would you call it?
Yeah, a little fly teaser on the back. Hook. Yep.
Wowee woo wah. I caught so many fish. I could pierce it through the wind. Yeah. Super easy to use. You know, you can use it, buzz it across the top,
yep.
Midwater, all the water columns you can cover with a simple epoxy. And what's great, if it has that single hook,
yeah,
all it has is one hook. Not damaging the fish at all, which is one of our main priorities for sure when we're fishing for schoolies.
Yeah.
Put them back so they can grow.
And then you're getting rid of the treble, you're putting the single hook on there. The action on it is increased. And just a little bit of flash can sometimes can make the difference between hooking up and not, you know?
For sure.
So, I am a culprit too. We're going topwater. These small topwaters work great. Heading Super Spook. I mean, it's classic. It's been around longer than I have. I know that for sure. So if you got these in your tackle tray, I would pull them out. Some are new arrivals. We got a nice little tsunami. Kind of walk the dog here. Again, in the 4-inch range. It's about finger length for me. Really nice rattle on these, pretty stout hooks, and then also be great as a double duty, use them for largemouth. Again, we're coming up to Yozuri here. He had the Mag Darter, which is beautiful. These are, this is the top knock. This is the, like a little silver with a rattle in there. Again, high quality hooks and split rings from Yozuri. This is like the white color, they make it in a bunch, but I think that universally you can kind of see white and bone here is a really good one. Mag Darter is beautiful. They have a really rear weighted system here. So the Mag Darter is gonna cast really far for its size and weight. Same thing here with the top knock. I love to use them for freshwater bass as well. They just work awesome.
We do have a lot of topwater stuff here. That's really because schoolies go crazy on the top.
Crazy.
And who doesn't wanna see topwater blowups? I mean,
yeah.
You can go most places, most back bays in the next couple of weeks.
Yep.
Next month here, they're going to be really starting to infiltrate, and that topwater action is going to be incredible. You know, I use the epoxy and kind of this 4-5, it's like a range finder,
mm-hmm.
Try and find them, and then once they get on the chew, they start busting up, so I toss that topwater in there.
And no complaints about the trout fishing on Cape Cod, but after a long winter of catching 2-pound trout, when you can get a 5-pound schoolie bust up, I mean, there's nothing better.
It's
than
tough. You got to go there.
Yeah.
Got to dive right into school yep. season for sure.
Some of these beautiful spring nights or mornings, you can have a lot of fun out there.
100%. Well, this is it, I would say, for our quick intro.
Yep.
You know, top five and some change.
Yeah.
Schoolie lures here. Expect to see a lot more from us, especially
yep.
this season. You know, the fish are just starting to swim up the coast.
Yep.
And when they get here, we're going to be doing all kinds of fun content. So make sure to do me a couple things. You gotta like the video.
Mm.
If we get to 100 likes, how about this? We'll do a giveaway. We'll do a giveaway.
Don't go crazy on it.
If you guys give us 100 likes in this video, let's see, what should I give them? We'll give you the brand new Tsunami. We'll give you a top-notch pencil. I'll give you an AB bomb because I did roast the boys at that.
Yeah.
Give them the AB bomb.
I will say, big one, much higher quality hooks and slit rings, and that's my go-to topwater over the dock.
And then two others. We'll get you Ron Z in the mix. And then let's go. We'll toss a squid in there too.
Ooh.
A great pack. So like the video. Get it to 100 likes. This is all yours. If not,
it's all mine.
It's all mine. I want to see comments, money bag emojis in there.
Ooh.
And also topics.
Yeah. Yeah. Give us some new ideas, you know?
But yeah, this has been Jake.
Money bags?
You know his name.
Come on now.
Expect to see more, folks.
I'm laughing straight to the bank with this. I'm laughing straight to the bank with this. I'm laughing. Work it out now. Show them work it out. I wanna see you break it down. Now back it up now.